Hello everyone, as we have done our previous activity on balance, today we are going to work on coordination and skills. So the objective behind this activity is that children will learn and practice balancing and will develop coordination and strength. So let's start. First, we'll do our warm-up activity. For that, I have shared you one link. You have to click on that link and you have to follow that video. So let's start with the first activity, which is animal walks. So first we are going to do duck walk. The objective of duck walk is that it helps to develop core strength, muscle strength, and it also helps to develop coordination and balance. So let's start this duck walk. This walk, you have to do it for 15 seconds of two sets. So let's start. You have to sit in this position, legs together, hands in this position, and you have to walk on your toes and you have to move your hands and legs together. You'll walk for 15 seconds and then you have to stop. Let's start a second animal walk, which is frog jump. The benefit of this frog jump is that it helps to develop our leg muscles. So let's start this frog jump. So I'll just show you how to do frog jump. You have to sit in this position, legs wide, and you have to jump forward. And again, you have to sit down. This, you have to do it for 15 seconds. Again, sit in this position, jump forward, and down. Let's start a third walk, which is bear walk. The benefit of this bear walk is that it helps start a third walk, which is bear walk. The benefit of the bear walk is that it strengthens the whole body and it also helps to develop the muscle power. So let's start this bear walk. I'll show you the position how to do a bear walk. So the first position is that if you keep your hands forward in this position and you have to walk like this for 15 seconds. Let's start our fourth walk, which is crab walk. So the benefit of the crab walk is that it helps to develop the strength of your shoulders and arms. So let's start this crab walk. So first you have to sit in this position and your hands should be facing towards your legs. So while doing this walk, you have to take your hip up and you have to walk without touching your hip down. You have to do this walk for 15 seconds without touching your hip down. You have to keep your elbows straight. Yoga kids. So let's start a second activity, which is kids yoga. So first we'll start with cobra pose. The benefit of cobra pose is that it helps to develop the strength of shoulders and arms and it also helps to increase your flexibility. So let's start. So for that we have to lie down on your stomach. You have to keep your legs straight. Your hands should be in this position and slowly you have to come up, shoulders back, and you have to look up. For 15 seconds, you have to hold this position and then down. So let's start a second pose, which is cat pose. The benefit of this cat pose is that it stretches your neck and your back. So let's start. So first you have to sit in this position. Your hands should be straight and you have to look up. Your back should be curved. Then you have to go down. Your neck should be down. So let's start with a cool down activity, which is Balasana, that is child pose. So you have to sit in this position. You have to sit on your legs in this position. Upper body straight, hands in this position. And you have to go slowly down, shoulders relaxed, and you have to touch your head down. You have to hold it for 15 seconds. So let's start a second cool down activity, which is Savasana. This activity you have to do it for 1 minute. So you have to lie down on your back, hands aside. Your leg should be straight. Legs relaxed, hands relaxed. You have to close your eyes and you have to do this for 1 minute without moving and talking. So your kinder play at home. So your today's kinder play at home challenge is that you have to hold the cat pose, camel pose and cobra pose for the maximum number of seconds and you have to record your best timing. Please share your video with us. Thank you.